So welcome back to my Dracula, the Lord of Shadow run. We're serious, our first playthrough ever in this game. Last time, in the last episode, we ended up exactly here and I killed the fat bitch that was there doing the cursing casting thing. I don't see any booby trap here. Why is it going to this room? It's not inside, just clean, you know. Really? Nothing here? I can have the candle. Took some time to break. Anyway, let's continue investigating this area. I'm feeling like, I know that the whip from my Simon Belmont is around this area. Yeah, I think it's in that room right there, I think. Cause I remember I googled it, you know, like where to find the whip, cause I wanted to be prepared how to make the other side. Oh shit, ah damn it, you cunt. Come on. Can you shit die? Fucking peace, man. Every time I try to get in my thoughts. Ooh. Oh, man. Alright. Let's see. We have to see that. Let's take the bow out and it's. Ah, man. Of course, it's not upgraded, so I'm guessing it will do inferior damage. But. I really cannot wait to use this on my Simon Belmont cosplay. Swing that thing for the first time. But it's okay, it's kinda slow. Kinda slow a little bit, but it's alright. This is the fast attack. Right here. Far better animation than the shitty animation of Dark Souls 1 and Dark Souls 2, you know. This one is the R2. See the power attack. That's pretty neat, man. Now, the run attack with R2. It's a pretty nice one. Yeah, this is gonna be the main weapon of my Simon Belmont whenever I get to this area. But first, I mean, I am working on this series. So, I mean, the thing is that it takes me so long, you know, to time that I barely, barely have to work on two series at the same time. So, I am focusing my time on this one, then... When this one is done, I'm gonna put all my full time for the Simon Belmont run. But I will be uploading the Simon Belmont playthrough, like something that's gonna come occasionally, you know. Oh, something's behind me. Damn it! Let's kill this guy with the whip. That's not too bad. At least it's staggered. No! Ah, almost got hit by that. Yeah, it's gonna be fun, man, when I play with my son. It's pretty cool. Let's see the special attack. Give me a sec, I'm gonna have to take the shield out. God damn it. Ah, that's pretty sweet, man. I shouldn't waste it, because I kinda need that MP for healing, but... Look at that, that's a thing of beauty. Back or forward attack. Let me see the run with the fast attack. The frontal hit. Okay. I'm guessing it will be a nice weapon, you know, when it's fully upgraded and when you infuse it with magic or holy damage, it's gonna become the true vampire killer. But I don't wanna use it on my Gabriel because I want him to have the badass, you know, combat cross chain. if we have something like that in this game, you bet your soul that I will be doing that. But in the meantime, let's just go with my sword. Because I'm making him more... Like, okay, this is my take on him, right? I want him to look like the Gabriel Belmont from Lords of Shadow 1. But I want him to be a swordsman, like he is on, like he's a Dracula form. So when he used, you know, the boy sword and all those epic weapons, just making sure I don't miss anything. So yeah, but now for my Simon, that's gonna be his main weapon. Now I don't know if a notch whip is better in terms of damage. I know it does bleed damage. But I don't know if it's overall better. I guess I'm gonna find that out. But for my Simon, I want to be like, you know, on the left hand, I want him to have a sword or axe, you know? And in the right hand, I want him to be wield the weapon. And it's gonna be no shield for the most part. So I'm gonna have to be rolling a lot to avoid damage. Should probably get killed many times because I lack a shield, but it's okay. So this one there. Now that area over there, I think is where is the bonfire. And as I understand it, you're gonna get invaded here by some NPC. But I know if you don't kill that NPC, you can access to an area that I don't know where is that area. But you can access to that area, and that area will guide you to a unique covenant. Kind of like a secret covenant. Like it's very hidden, you know? Wow, look at this place, man. It looks so twisted. It reminds me of the Van Helsing movie. The way they put it, the twisted, you know, little creepy town from Transylvania. So yeah, what I'm trying to say is that I don't know if I should kill that invader. Like, maybe I should run away or... I don't know. Because I know if you don't kill him on the first time, you will talk with that NPC that is the guy that is invading you. But I really had no clue where. I think it's maybe going that way. Somewhere around this area. Oh, maybe it's on that side of the colony, I think. Now, I'm gonna try to make this jump. I think it's a shitty jump, but I'm gonna try to make it. Count! Oh, yes. I will. Ah, fuck you, Crystal. Sean, I'll get you later. A rusty coin. That's a good drop. And I believe we already have. Oh no, we haven't. So this is what you use for the luck rating, for the drops. So I'm gonna make sure to use that when I'm farming my dark sword from the dark wraith. I'm gonna use my spell just in case. Yeah, it's cool that they made a better, like, they truly did make better focus on the whip in this game. And I know that, you know, the developers, FromSoft, at least the Miyazaki guy, I know that he's a huge fan of the old school Castlevania games, like at least the very old ones, the Nintendo and the PC. I know that he grew up with those, and he said that he loved those games, and you know, and actually they took a lot of reference from those games to build their Souls game, same way they did with the Ninja Gaiden series, and Ghouls and Goblins, so... Ooh, we got a new enemy there. Shit. Alright, let's go. I think we're gonna get invaded sometime soon. I still don't have the key to open that door, but the way I'm thinking it is that I'm gonna have to go around and search this area first. That's what I'm gonna do. And I don't know if I'm gonna get invaded right now before I do that. Probably will. But if I do, I'm gonna just run for it. I'm gonna get a jump here. No? think it's when you go a little bit forward that direction that you get invaded by that NPC, but I don't know. I haven't even fought it for real, but I know it's not that hard. Just like all NPCs that you fight. Okay, I've been here already. Okay, we need to go back here now. Now we're gonna go to the other side of this town. I'm trying to remember what are the steps that you need to enter to that covenant. I don't know if something had to do with this door right here. It doesn't open from that side, okay. Fuck. Yeah. Oh yeah, the hole. The hole, that hole. Okay, makes sense. I don't know if I'm gonna get jumped by anything here. Man, I didn't jump in that hole before because I didn't use Warrior Sunlight. Yes. I got the trophy, Covenant Warrior of the Sunlight. Hell yeah, man. Praise the sun, okay? Oh, by the way, I got this one from one of the players that he was a Sombra. That's his medallion that he gave to me when I was playing online helping other people. So where is it? Oh, it's one of these, okay. Ancient Death Talisman. That's pretty cool, man. I don't know, I am more of the way of the blue. I just like to be a sentinel. I like to be a sentinel of the blue. And kill invaders. Drink ecstasy. Huh? Oh, I can refill my ecstasy glass, man. Is that it? Oh, that's pretty cool. Alright. Let's see. Vampire killer. You don't look so retro Velma, man. Love that shit. Now we can open this door. Oh yeah, man. It's gonna feel so Castlevania when I play my Simon like this, man. All the way through the game with the whip, you know. Now let's go to that other area of the map. Here I've been already. I like the jump attack with the web, it's pretty neat. Scare me a little bit. Ooh, that doesn't look good. I get my bow in a second. With fire arrows, please. Got that guy down. Zombies. I don't know if those barrels are gonna explode or not, but find out in the hard way, you know. I think there is another area coming up here. What is that sound? Sounds like steps. There's a big guy waiting there. I see him. You don't fool me, buddy. You got a big yard on you, huh? Is that explosive arrow right there? I think it is. I think it is explosive. God damn it, I missed my chance. Whatever. Let's go. What are you gonna do with that, son? Huh? Okay. What else? Damn it. Of course, can I be a perfect kill, huh? That may be too good for the first time. It's alright. Just one shitty hit box, whatever. But anyway, I don't really complain for the most part of the rolling in this game, you know. When it works right, it works really, really well. Just like in Bloodborne, which I love. Far better than the crappy, horrible rolling of Dark Souls 2, you know, which they really fuck up so bad. By the way, I do love Dark Souls 2, but it got a lot of issues. Oh, this is gonna come behind me to push me. Is that one of those giant with the jar appear like right in a place like this in the corner? You like this? Would be so bad. Oh, a fire cross ring. Got my second ring, third ring. Yes, love it. So we got that ring that increases fire attack, compromises damage. What? Increases fire attack, compromise damage. By the same item, you mean? Okay, well, I'm not doing any fire damage anyway, but... double V like fire damage, I don't know. Fire resistance or something like that, I don't really have it. It's okay. Really loving the creepy look of this game. I don't remember this area. You know what? Before I do anything else, I'm gonna go I'm gonna go over there, passing this bridge, because I know that is the place that's gonna take me to the fastest dark soul in this game. So I'm gonna do that because it's gonna be my main weapon in the game. It looks so badass, man. I think it's gonna be one of the best weapon choices that I'm gonna be doing for my Dracula. Now that weapon, it doesn't have the stab attack of this one, but you will see it. It is an amazing weapon, though. I'm not sure it's gonna be part, like a vital part of this build. Oh yeah, I haven't been through this area. I remember where this guy is trying to shadow me. Oh yeah, he's gonna die. Am I gonna hit? Ah, he can barely reach me. That's good for me. Surprisingly, I didn't go hit by him. I love the loot in this game, man. I'm just so happy that this thing came out of nowhere. Oh shit. Is that thing doing any kind of damage at all? I think so. No, I didn't want to waste my... I'm gonna need to go back to the camp and buy more fire arrows. Fuck off, little shit. I've been thinking, since I'm doing archery... Well, for those that don't know, I already did a Legolas cosplay series of Dark Souls 2. It's on my channel, you can look for the playlist if you are interested into that. You know, a dexterous rogue archer build. But in this game, I'm feeling like I can also do that too. But I can do a Robin Hood. Oh shit! Role-playing series too. Because I just, you know, I love Robin Hood. He's one of my favorite, you know, classic heroes from old England. So, a fading soul, really? All that for a stupid trap, man. So I've been thinking a lot about doing that. I want to make like a build that focuses on archery. A plank. You mean a piece of shit shield? That's what it should say in the description. Never like the shields, man. And oh yeah, I was about to show this, but I remembered I get jumped by the enemy, and I forgot to show it, so sorry. See right here, it's a piece of shit in every aspect, man. It's not even good on lightning absorption. Why they would do that? Why they will developers will kill, you know, the potential to bring a real good item just to put a shitty one that nobody will use, you know? Is this? Oh, the NPC.
Another Nana disappeared. The Granton carries a cage. He ever has his cage.
Crazy bastard.
And Nana's never coming back. So come into the cage and become Nana's shade.
Look at this guy, man.
Another Nana disappeared. The Granton carries a cage. He ever has his cage. And Nana's never coming back. So come into the cage and become Nana's shade.
Okay, I think I know how. I did have a little bit of spoiling regarding that, so I know a little bit. I wasn't sure where the NPC was located. And I even forgot how the NPC is supposed to look. But now I recall. I don't remember the name of the channel I saw that, but I saw a little bit of that. Homeward. Okay, so I was there. And I think there is one of those big guys that has a cage behind him. So you are not supposed to kill that guy. Wait a moment. I don't remember. I think it's around this. But what I do remember is that... Okay, I had to jump from above, I think. And if I die, man, I'm so fucking pissed. Anyway, I think I kind of remember a little bit. I think we had to run, we jumped from this roof. Yeah, it's gonna do too much damage to me, man. Oh, shit. That guy, after to talk to him, I think... Now, don't quote me on that 100%, but I think he won't be aggro to me. I think he won't be my enemy. I think you get behind him. And if you get into this... Yeah, you see, you can examine and you can get inside that. But before I do that, I'm gonna grab this item. Oh, shit! No! Where's the item's gonna go? Oh, it's gonna stay there. Okay, that's good. There's nothing else? Yeah, that's it. That's it about this area. Look at the look of this place, man. Wow. That is that giant over there. That's good. Well, alright, Dracula. Oh, wait a moment. There's something here. No, it's barricade. Alright. I think if we press the X button, but how we get out of here? I see the connection. Okay, I get it. You see, he won't attack me, which is cool. And this happens when you get behind him, which is very awesome. glad I didn't go invader, because I didn't want to kill that invader without this cutscene. My armor looks more broken on the cutscene, I think. What the? That's funny. Gabriel, get up! Dracul! The Impalia! Get up, bro. Well, I guess I'll be going to show this tutorial after all. I have to. Look at this area, man. Now, this is a very obscure place. I'm actually glad that I saw that video, because that way I won't be ruining the chance of showing that on this playthrough, you know. What is this item right here? A wooden... Let's talk to him first, and I'm gonna examine that shield. Look at you.
Well, what's up? This pit is for hollows, not for the likes of you, sane folk. Or perhaps you are a hollow, posing as otherwise?
Not a bad armor. I guess I'm gonna say indeed.
Yes, yes. Then we are just fine. It's important to know who you are. But we'll all be mad soon enough. And should you be undead, well, all the more so. Beware. The shackles of the gods are fragile. You might need this. Etch it on your heart if you feel your sanity slipping.
Mound-maker. Now got a trophy called Covenant Mound-makers.
Come here to pile up your victims, for that will form your anchor. You'll see when you go mad. They'll be your family.
Damn you.
You'll go mad one day, but not today. Take my advice. Use this bone and leave this place.
Thanks, man.
This pit is for hollows and for the occasional madman fond of piling up victims. You've better things to do, I'd hope.
Kind of like a little bit of the armor, the top part.
This pit is for hollows and for the occasional madman fond of piling up victims. You've better things to do, I'd hope.
So I think it's one of those government things what he gave me. Now I'm trying to remember, I'm trying to remember if you had to be hollow to be part of this. So luckily it's a good thing then if I die by accident when I was away from the controller, so.
This pit is for hollows. And for the
So if I get part of
this pew.
I thought he can sell me stuff, but I guess not. Oh yeah, I had to pray at this thing. Offer vertebra shackle. I don't have any, right? No. It's good. Now I don't understand what is the point of this government, like what they really do. I had to go and search the lore about this, so maybe it says in the description, but well, at least we got this area down. Now what is gonna suck is that I have to go back and awake all my enemies again and kill them all over again. But it's okay. We're gonna make a cut and go back to that area that I was before I come here. I'm just trying to take a look around the place, just to show it a little bit. So anyway, on the next episode, we're gonna get closer to that area where I can get my Dark Sword of Honor.